Hello everyone, myself Sanjay Udge from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur, Department of Electronics Engineering. Today we are going to discuss DC circuits. Learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to analyze different electrical laws like KVL, KCL, parallel circuits, series circuits. Guidelines. Introduction, then Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's voltage law, Kirchhoff's current law, properties of series circuit, properties of parallel circuit, resistivity. Introduction, engineering, application of scientific and mathematical principles towards practical end, for example, design, manufacture, process control. Electrical engineering. It is that branch of engineering science which deals with the electrical phenomena, or it is that branch of engineering science which relates with the problems associated with the large-scale electrical system, for example, generation. Let us define current. Current is the flow of electrons. Mathematically, it is given by I is equal to dq by dt, that is a rate of change of charge per unit time. Unit of the current is ampere. Potential difference. It is the work done in bringing a unit positive charge from one point to another point. Its unit is volts. Ohm's law. Voltage across the conductor is directly proportional to the current flowing through that conductor. Mathematically, it is given by V is equal to I into R, where V stands for voltage, current, and IR stands for resistance. Here is the circuit, DC supply shown by a battery. Then a resistor is connected across it. Across a resistor, there is a voltmeter to read the voltage across this resistor, that is the voltage drop across it, and an ammeter in series with them. Okay, so when the battery is turned on, the current will flow through the resistance, and if you take the readings of ammeter and voltmeter, it will definitely satisfy the Ohm's law, V is equals to I into R, for a given value of a resistance. Sign conventions. Here a resistor is shown across which a voltage drop is V1, current flowing is I1. If my direction of tracing is from top to bottom, okay, current is also having a same direction, I1 current, and my direction, if it is same, the drop is said to be negative. And if in the second figure, I2, which is going in the upward direction, and if I am coming, my tracing direction is from positive to negative, that is my tracing direction and the correction direction I2 are opposite. Okay, in that case we can say that it's a positive drop. And if my direction and the I2 direction is correct, due to the same direction, the it will be a negative voltage drop. Similar for the power, Kirchhoff's voltage law. It is the fundamental conservation law. Here, energy cannot be created nor it is destroyed. A statement of this KVL is, the algebraic sum of the voltages around any closed path equals to zero. It can be also stated that algebraic sum of the product of currents and resistances in each of the conductors in any closed path in a network plus the algebraic sum of the EMFs in the path is zero. Here is the equation, summation of IR. IR means it's a voltage drop across each and every resistance in a closed path, plus summation of number of sources is equals to zero. Here again, a circuit diagram is shown for the Kirchhoff's voltage law. A battery supply VS, then two series resistances R1 and R2. Here, same current I is flowing through R1 and R2. Here the loop is shown consisting of a closed loop starting from Vs R1 R2 and back to negative terminal of the voltage supply Vs DC supply. Here, according to KVL, Vs must be equals to I into R1 plus I into R2. That is, the supply voltage must be equals to the drop across R1 plus drop across R2. Kirchhoff's voltage law. Now, if we trace the circuit in clockwise direction, some of the voltage drops will be. Let us start from voltage source V1. So, I am going from positive terminal to the negative terminal since I am tracing this circuit in clockwise direction. So, it is minus V1. Then coming to V2, it is from positive to negative. My direction is from positive to negative. So, it will be a minus V2. Next, the third source is V3. Again, it is from positive to negative, so that will be considered as V3. So, in clockwise direction, in summary, the equation will be minus V1, minus V2, minus V3 equals to 0. Now, if we trace the same circuit in anti-clockwise direction, the equation will become V1 plus V2 plus V3 is equals to 0. The reason behind this, why the sign is changed for V1, V2, V3 from negative to positive? Because while going from the anti-clockwise direction, I will first meet to a negative terminal of the battery, then the last terminal will be positive for all these three cases, that is V3, V2 and V1. So that's why the equation will be V1 plus V2 plus V3 is equals to 0. Now here is the question, find VAD and VFC. Okay, here is the answer. VAD, from going VAD, it is the voltage at terminal A with respect to terminal D. That is, D is considered as a common or reference point. So while finding out the voltage VAD, I will start from point A and I will reach to D. Now coming back to this earlier slide, D, I will start now from D. Here is a 12 volt, so after point D, first is the 12 volt plus, then it is minus sign is there, so it's a minus 12 volt, then C point, then at 10 volt again it is plus to minus, again it is minus 10, and from B onwards it's a again minus 8 volt, and finally 20 volt, it is plus 20 volt. So the equation becomes VAD is equals to minus 12, minus 10, minus 8, plus 20, so it comes out to be VAD is equals to minus 10 volt. Now VFC, how is VFC? So that is voltage at potential at point F with respect to C being considered as a common or reference point. So VFC, I will start from C. Now first is the 12 volt, it is from negative to positive, that will be a positive drop. Then D, after D, it's a 30 volts, that will be negative, minus 30 volts. Then point E, then 15 volts, it is minus 50, minus 2 plus 15. So the equation becomes VFC minus 12 plus 30 minus 15 equals to 0. And finally, VFC is equal to minus 3 volts. Kirchhoff's current law, it is also called as point law statement. The algebraic sum of current meeting at the junction is zero. In other words, sum of currents entering the junction is equals to the sum of the currents. Series circuit. In this circuit, we are having a battery between terminals 1 and 4. Between terminals 1 and 2, it's a R1. Between 2 and 3, it's a R2. And between 3 and 4, it's a R3. The series circuit, it's a simple series combination of various resistances. Here I have shown three resistances R1, R2, R3 connected across a single voltage source. If you observe the same current flows through the circuit, okay, and the voltage drop is to V1, V2, V3, which is the voltage drop across three resistances, must be equals to this supply voltage. Parallel circuit. Here is the parallel circuit R1, R2, R3. They are parallel, that is, they are connected across supply voltage. Okay. Here, the most important property of the parallel circuit is there is a division of the current. Okay. Here, another important property is the same voltage, supply voltage is appearing across R1, R2 and R3. Here there is a division of the current. Equivalent resistance of the network is 1 upon R equivalent is equals to summation of reciprocals of all resistances. Voltage divider is a simple circuit having a single voltage source and a series resistance network through which we can derive number of voltages to be fed to the different networks. That is, we can derive two or more voltages from a single voltage source. Current division. This rule is applied to only two parallel resistances such that battery EMF is shown across two parallel resistances R1, R2. Total current IT is equal to summation of I1 plus I2. Here I can write as I1 is equal to IT into opposite parallel resistance R2 upon R1 plus R2. Whereas I2 is equal to total current IT into R1, opposite resistance R1 upon R1 plus R2. Specific resistance. What is the difference between resistance and resistivity? Resistance is R is equal to rho L upon A, whereas resistivity is rho is equal to Ra upon L. Resistance is dependent on temperature, then nature of the material, as well as area and length, whereas resistivity depends only on temperature and the nature. It doesn't depend upon length and the area, and this is said to be intrinsic property, because if the amount of the material change, the resistivity is not going to change, but the resistance will definitely change. That is, R is equal to rho L upon A. This is the reference. I have taken the reference from B.L. Theraja.